Coach, there's no doubt about it. This is a tough week for you guys. You know the history of the last three games between these two teams. Talk about why New Pal is maybe just as good as they were last year.
Well, I mean, I think that they are as big and strong and as physical as anybody that we see. You know, their coach is in his second or third year. He's done a great job with that program. You know, New Pal has historically had some good programs, but they kind of fell on tough times for a year or two. But coach up there is doing a great job, got them believing. You know, the kids are, like I said, are as strong as anybody that we're going to see up and down the line. And they just have a good thing rolling right now. You know, we're going to have to come out and play well you know, try to match your intensity from the start and, you know, try to match your physicality and maybe try to utilize some of our athleticism you know, see if that gives us a shot.
You know, I know it's just a small survey when they beat Danville the way they did. They beat them that way 2 years in a row. But how they've come back with another quarterback that's a multi-talented, you know, run-pass guy and a very, very good running back again. It's unusual, though, to kind of reload like that.
Well,
For
good programs, it's not. They just reload every year. And that's what... That's what New Pal is. I mean, and that's what, you know, we hope that we're striving to be and wanting to be, regardless of who we have and what we don't have. But yeah, good programs just find a way year in, year out with their system, with their kids, with how they believe. You know, that they just have talent up and down the system. So for me, it doesn't really surprise me. You know, maybe I wish it was a little bit different, but you know, it is what it is. And you know, I think we have a good challenge before us, and I think that's how we are approaching it. You know, obviously, we've had some success at the conference level, have not had the success we wanted to at the state level. And this is a great opportunity, to go against a quality team ranked in the top five, in their respective class, and just kind of see where we're at.
I think they call their offense the power spread or something in that nature.
Sure.
What makes it different?
Well, I mean, they spread you out. They can be an up-tempo team. They're no huddle. Do spread you out, but they run the ball. I mean, that's what they do. That's what they do well. They're, like I said before, their kids are big and strong and physical. They have about 115-pound running back that runs hard and is tough to bring down. You know, when you look at honestly, when you look at some of what the colleges are doing and, you know, the first inception of the spread was kind of, you know, chuck the ball around and this and that. But a lot of teams are starting to realize that, hey, you know, they have to honor the formations and they spread you out and they try to create mismatches. And when they do in the run game as well as the passing game, they're just going to continue to hammer you on it.
You know, their defense played really well in their first game, too. I think they held the opponents well under 150 yards. What did they do defensively that you might be able to exploit this week?
Well, I mean, they keep it pretty simple. We talked last week going into Connersville, not really knowing for sure what we were going to get defensively. I mean, they are a three-stack defense. That's what they do. That's what they do very well. They blitz a lot. I thought... You know, we've talked a little bit about Pendleton early on during the scrimmage, but they just have a very physical attacking type defense, and they blitz a lot. And you know, when you blitz a lot, you know, sometimes you can catch them in particular things and pop a good one, or if you recognize the blitz early on and you can find a hole in their defense, you take advantage of it. So, I mean, that's sort of where we're at right now is we just. The linemen have been working very hard and picking up the blitz and including the back on the pass blitz pickup and just knowing and recognizing what they're doing and just trying to find the holes or the weaknesses as the game develops.
With that style that they play coming at you, go back to last week and after looking at the film, did you see something in your offensive line that you liked, something maybe that you, because we talked after the game and you said you saw a lot of good things, but after watching film, was it as good or did you see areas that you want to get better at?
Well, depending upon how you want to look at film, it's never as good as you think the night before and it's never as bad as you think it was the night before.
Right.
I mean, the line played very well. I mean, we obviously still had some some missed blocks and some issues as far as the correct blocks, trying to block the right guys. But I did like the fact that they kind of took pride, a little bit of ownership. You know, we've talked about them a little bit being the, you know, the kind of the question mark in the deal, and I think they took that to heart. And I think as the game went on, and especially as, you know, we get the ball, I guess at this point it's a one touchdown game. We get the ball with about 6 minutes left in the game, and they really decided, hey, we are going to grind this thing out and win this thing and get it done. So, you know, despite some of the things that we saw that, you know, that that we've been working on this week to try to correct, I think just the mentality of, hey, look, we're put the team on our back. We're going to go get the win. And so, you know, I kind of like that.
Says a lot about them, doesn't it, to do that?
Yeah, I think it does. I think it does. I think, as we talk about the pass or the running game, you know, there's going to be a time that the passing game is the one that's going to have to carry us. And you also want those guys at that point to say, hey, let us, you know, do this. But especially a group that, you know, as we said, we returned one starter from last year, and he's not even playing the same position that he did last year. Yeah. For those guys to be able to step up and say, hey, coach, you know, without a sense of arrogance about, hey, run behind me, we got this, we can do this, that's always a nice feeling as a coach when the kids take that approach and can carry through with it.
Never really thought about that, but with Schaefer being at center, it's almost like having five new offensive linemen.
Yeah, it really is. It really is. Yep.
Coach, you ran the ball very well last week, and I guess sometimes when we think about Richmond, you know, throwing the football and maybe not quite as well last week as you had hoped, or maybe you didn't really need to since you're able to run the football. Any concerns this week about throwing the football against New Pal?
You know, there's a concern every week about everything, but no, I mean, I think it's just a matter of getting in rhythm and getting in line with things, and I think we've had another week of practice, and we've been working on some things that we think we hopefully can take advantage of in how they do things. So, I mean, there's always a concern, but there's also a calm confidence that, hey, We prepared the best that we can. We think the kids are ready to play. Now it's just a matter of going out and doing it.
I can't believe that I'd ever ask you if there's a concern, right?
you know me better than that.
Yeah. You're home this week, and I know that's always exciting to play at Leibold Field. And just now it's become more just not just a football game, but an event. Richmond has really done a nice job of making it a gathering place on Friday night.
Yeah, it's such a great atmosphere. Chad Bolser kind of started off making it an event and a thing to go and do and be a part of. Hopefully it's about the football game out there.
Yeah.
But no, I think between the music playing and the tent down in the end zone and honoring people every week and the band playing and those kinds of things, it really is just a great atmosphere to play, and it is an easy atmosphere to feed off of it while you're out there on the field.